In this video, I'll show you how to send CloudWatch alarms to the Slack channel. When we create a new CloudWatch alarm, we will get a Slack message that the new alarm was registered. To test integration, we will configure this CloudWatch alarm to fire up when the CPU usage of the EC2 instance exceeds 80%. We can also send the message to Slack when the alarm is resolved. The way it's going to work is the following. When the CloudWatch alarm fires up, it will send a message to the SNS topic. Then this message will trigger the Lambda function. It will parse the payload with an alarm message and send a custom message to the Slack channel based on the current and previous state of the alarm. To create this notification pipeline, we will use the AWS console, as well as I'll show you how to reproduce this setup using the Terraform code. First of all, we need to create an SNS topic. CloudWatch will use it to publish messages based on the alarm conditions that we will define later. It can be a standard SNS topic with a name alarms. When you are just getting started, I would suggest that you enable logging for your topic. It can save you a lot of time when you develop your notification pipeline with a Lambda function. As with any other AWS service, SNS would need a set of permissions to push logs to the CloudWatch. Let's create an IAM role for the SNS topic first. Search for SNS under Use Cases for other AWS services, then select SNS. This role already comes with a single IAM policy that will allow SNS topics to write messages to the CloudWatch log group. Let's call it SNS logs. Next, we need to update the SNS topic to use this role, but before, don't forget to copy the ARN. Then under Delivery Status Logging, click Edit. We only need to choose AWS Lambda Protocol, since that's the only service that will be subscribed to this topic. Only for testing, set to log every single message. For production, set it to zero or close to it, otherwise, you'll get a large AWS bill. Then enter the ARN of the SNS logs IAM role for both successful and failed deliveries. Let me show you how to create exactly the same SNS topic using Terraform. First, we need to define the SNS logs IAM role. Then attach the same Amazon SNS role IAM policy to the role that we just defined. And the alarms topic itself. Here you can also adjust the sample rate and provide IAM roles to push logs to CloudWatch. Next, we need to create a Slack channel to receive CloudWatch alarms and a Slack app. For the channel, use alarms name. To create a Slack app, go to api.slack.com/apps and click Create an App. Choose Create an App from scratch and call it CloudWatch Alarms. You also need to select the Slack workspace. We're going to be using webhooks to receive events from CloudWatch. Go ahead and activate incoming webhooks and add it to the Alarm Slack channel. Slack will generate a URL that we can use from Lambda to publish messages. Optionally, you can add an app icon and a short description, something like sends AWS alerts to Slack. The next step is to create an AWS Lambda function. If you decide to create this function from the console, AWS can generate an IAM role for you, which is fine when you are just getting started, but the better approach is to create those IAM roles and policies yourself. Select Lambda from the common use cases. Then we need to grant permissions for our Lambda to write logs to CloudWatch. For that, you can use one of the predefined IAM policies called AWS Lambda Basic Execution Role. Call this role Send CloudWatch Alarms to Slack. Now we can create Lambda itself. Select Create a function from scratch. Give it a name, Send CloudWatch Alarms to Slack. For the runtime, choose the last available Python version. In my case, it's Python 3.9. Since we created the IAM role, specify it as well. then the function itself. In a nutshell, it sends a message to the Slack channel when you register a new CloudWatch alarm. When the alarm is triggered, you'll get a custom message with the name of the alarm and a condition. Also, you'll get another message when the alarm is resolved. Port a couple of libraries and define the Slack URL. I have another video explaining how to use secrets in your Lambda function. You would want it to store it in AWS KMS and pull it from the instead of hardcoding in your function. You can find the Slack URL under webhook URL. The first function will simply parse the SNS message with the alarm. Then let's define a few functions that will return the Slack message. We use a Slack block kit to build the message. For example, this function will be used when we need to send a message to Slack when we register a new CloudWatch alarm. The next activate_alarm function is used when we need to send an actual alarm to the channel. And the last one will be used when the alarm is resolved. The last function is a lambda_handler with logic on when to send different alarms. The logic is pretty simple. SNS message will contain the current state of the alarm and the previous one. For example, when you just register a new CloudWatch alarm, it will take a few seconds or even minutes to collect the necessary data. When the alarm transitions from insufficient data to the OK state, we can send a Slack message that a new CloudWatch alarm was registered. Same thing with other states. Now we can deploy the function. If you want to subscribe your Lambda to an SNS topic using the console, it's very easy. Add a trigger and select the SNS topic. Behind the scene, AWS will add a resource-based policy to the function and add a subscription to the topic. It's a little bit more complicated to create Lambda using Terraform. First, we need to create an S3 bucket to store zip archives with Lambda sources. Each S3 bucket must be unique. For that, let's generate a random string with a pet name. Then create the bucket itself. You can also disable public access to this bucket since it will be used only internally. Then create folders for the Lambda function. And a file function.py. It's going to be exactly the same Python function we defined in the AWS console. Parse SNS message. Then create three different functions to send proper messages to Slack. And define the logic of when to use those message templates based on the current and previous alarm states. Now the Terraform code to create Lambda. The first is an IAM role. Then attach basic execution role with permissions to write logs to CloudWatch to Lambda. Archive_file will take the source of the function and produce a zip archive in the same folder. Then we're going to take that zip and upload it to the S3 bucket. The etag parameter will let us automatically redeploy the Lambda function if the source code has changed. Then the Lambda. Specify the name, runtime, handler and point to the S3 object as a source for the function. We can also create a CloudWatch group with a retention policy of 2 weeks. To subscribe Lambda to the SNS topic, first, we need to grant SNS permissions to invoke our function. Then use topic subscription to subscribe Lambda to the alarm's SNS topic. Finally, let's create a CloudWatch alarm. We can only specify a single metric for the alarm. This means for each EC2 instance, we have to create a new alarm unless you use an auto-scaling group. With automation or Terraform, it's not a big deal. Go to metrics, EC2, per instance metrics, and paste the ID of the EC2 instance. We're going to be using CPU utilization metric for this alarm. Then the condition, if the CPU utilization for the EC2 instance is equal to or greater than 80%, trigger the alarm. Then select the SNS topic where you want to publish alerts. To get notifications when the alarm is resolved, add another OK action to the same SNS topic. You need to provide both alarm name and description since our Lambda expects both attributes, otherwise, Lambda will fail. To create the same CloudWatch alarm with Terraform, you just need a single resource. Since we create EC2 with Terraform, we can dynamically pull EC2 ID from the Terraform resource. Then the same metric namespace and a name. The key is to specify the instance ID as your dimension for the alarm. And pretty much the same threshold of 80%. To send SNS messages from this alarm, you need to provide OK and alarm actions with the SNS topic. We can use Terraform reference since we define SNS topic using Terraform as well. Now let's test. You should get a Slack message in a few seconds after you register a new alarm and the state of that alarm transition to OK. To test the CPU threshold, we can SSH to Ubuntu and use the stress tool to simulate high CPU usage. First, install it with the apt install stress command and use it to produce the load on the system. In a few minutes, the CPU should exceed 80%, and you should get an alarm in the Slack channel. When you stop the stress utility, the CPU should drop, and another message that the alarm was resolved should be sent to Slack. Thank you for watching. If you have any suggestions or topics for the next videos, please post them in the comments.